Hi, boys and girls. Nice to see you guys today. I'm so excited to get to join you all this Sunday and share with you a story from the Word of God. We are going to be learning today how God is our friend. And we'll be reading from Psalm chapter 25. And in this passage, we're going to learn how David, I think some of you have heard of him, he eventually becomes King David, writes a song praising God, and in it, he talks about characteristics of God that sounds a lot like a friend. God is trustworthy, he gives good advice, he loves you, forgives you, helps you make the right choices, and helps you when you're in trouble. He is an amazing friend, and that brings us to our Bible point for this week. God is our friend. And our summary verse that we've been working on for the past few weeks: no power in the sky above or in the earth below, indeed, nothing in all creation will ever be able to separate us from the love of God that is revealed in Christ Jesus our Lord. Romans 8, verse 39. So, today's Bible story is actually a song. And we don't know the tune to it, so we're just going to be reading the words. But it's a song written by David, and he showed us how God is our friend. So before we dig any deeper, let's take a moment to pray and get us started in today's lesson. Let's bow our heads and close our eyes. Dear Lord, we thank you for this day that you have made, this day that you have given us, this opportunity that you have presented us so that we may learn more about you. We thank you for showing us the qualities of an amazing friend and for just continuously loving us and showing us how much you love us. We thank you for all of that, and we ask you to please open up our hearts as we dig into this story today so that we can understand what it truly means to be a friend. We ask you this in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, my friends. So again, today we're going to be reading from Psalm chapter 25, and I'll just let you know as we go through some of those verses that describe the qualities of an amazing friend. Okay? Now, if I ask you, what are some good qualities in a friend? You might say someone who's kind, someone who is loyal, maybe someone who likes to share their things with you. I know I like it when my friends share with me. Someone who is helpful. And those are all very good qualities of a friend. Today, we are learning that God is our friend. But does he show the qualities we're looking for in a friend? Some of those I mentioned, maybe some of the other ones that you have thought of. Let's see how a guy in the Bible named David described God. I'm going to read a few verses and see what qualities of a friend they describe. Okay, so first we're going to read Psalm chapter 25, verses 1 through 3. And that says, "In you, Lord my God, I put my trust. I trust in you. Do not let me be put to shame, nor let my enemies triumph over me. No one who hopes in you will ever be put to shame, but shame will come on those who are treacherous without cause." So in these first three verses of Psalm 25, we see how God is described as being trustworthy. I put my trust in you. Okay, and that is a great quality for a friend, someone who is trustworthy. You can say things to and know that they will keep it a secret if that's what it needs to, if that's what you're asking them to do. And just someone that you can trust, okay, and share your life experiences with, things that make you happy, things that make you sad. If we continue reading verses 4 and 5, those say, "Show me your ways, Lord. Teach me your paths. Guide me in your truth and teach me. For you are God, my Savior, and my hope is in you all day long." And in these next two verses, we're seeing how God gives good advice. Okay? David has now said that God is trustworthy. He makes a trustworthy friend. And he gives good advice. Teach me your path. Show me your ways. Okay? You only ask someone to show you their ways if you think that they give you good advice. Okay? All right. Now we're going to move on to verse 6. And that says, remember, Lord, your great mercy and love, for they are far from old. And that is a reminder that God loves you and that a friend loves you, wants the best for you. Someone who wants the best for you loves you. All right. So he is trustworthy, gives good advice, loves you. We continue on verse 7. Do not remember the sins of my youth and my rebellious ways. According to your love, remember me, for you, Lord, are good. Okay. Do not remember the sins of my youth. Okay, David is talking about a friend who can forgive him. Someone who can forgive you is so important because we are not perfect. We might do things that upset others, and a good friend will always forgive you. Okay, so God is trustworthy, gives good advice, loves us, and forgives us. And now we're going to read verses 8 through 10. Good and upright is the Lord. Therefore, he instructs sinners in his ways. He guides the humble in what is right and teaches them his ways. All the ways of the Lord are loving and faithful toward those who keep the demands of his covenant. So here we see how God helps us make the right choices. He not only gives us good advice, but he's here to help you make the right choices, okay? He instructs sinners in his ways, and he guides the humble in what is right and teaches them his way. So he's helping us, or he will help us, make the right choices, good choices. Finally, we're going to skip a little bit to verses 15 through 22 to see how God can help us when we're in trouble, which is another great quality of a friend. Verse 15 says, my eyes are ever on the Lord, for only he will rise my feet from the snare. Turn to me and be gracious to me, for I am lonely and afflicted. Relieve the troubles of my heart and free me from my anguish. Look on my affliction and my distress and take away all my sins. See how numerous are my enemies and how fiercely they hate me. Guard my life and rescue me. Do not let me be put to shame, for I take refuge in you. May integrity and uprightness protect me, because my hope, Lord, is in you. Deliver Israel, O God, from all their troubles. So these seven verses help us see how God helps us when we're in trouble. And these are some very good qualities that we could look for in a friend, in addition to maybe some of the ones that you thought of at the beginning of the lesson. So in Psalm 25, we see how David describes God as being trustworthy, giving good advice, loving us and forgiving us, helping us make the right choices, and number 6, helping us when we are in trouble. What difference does it make to you that God is our friend? Well, God is our friend, and he's better than any human friend that we can have. Now, I'm sure if I asked you to make a list of friends, you might start with your best friends, your best friends, and then your pretty good friends. These are my good friends. And then you've got maybe your regular friends. And then just under regular friends, maybe you've got those friends that come and go. You don't talk to very much. You don't see very much. But if you maybe see them at another friend's birthday party or a cousin's birthday party, you get along with them. So they might be your friend for that day, okay? We've got all these different levels of friendship. But no matter where any one of those friends fall in your friends category, we're all human. We can all make mistakes. We may all need forgiveness. We may not want to be kind at some point. It might not be our first reaction. And so God surpasses all of those traits because he is not human. He is perfect. Okay? So that's what makes him our most special friend. He'll never stop loving us, and he's with us all the time. So sometimes human friends aren't available when you need them. And especially right now, where we may not be able to see our friends as often as we would, or even our cousins as often as we'd like, because of the coronavirus and people being sick, and maybe you have to do more Zoom or FaceTime, or maybe you do get to hang out with them, but only outside, and it's so hot that you don't want to do too much out there, right? But despite all of those things, God is there with us all the time, and you can talk to him through prayers, and you can share your worries with him, and he can help put you at ease. God is always there for you, and I hope that that is the message that sticks to you guys today. God is our friend. He's always there for us, and he's perfect. He's literally our most perfect friend, okay? So in a time when maybe you wish you were actually going to school so that you could see your friends, but instead you have to see them online, it's a make you feel good kind of something, knowing that God is our friend and that he's there for us all the time. So I'd like to wrap up today's lesson with a word of prayer. So please join me in bowing your heads and closing your eyes with me. Dear Lord, we thank you for today's lesson, and we thank you for being our friend. We thank you for being our most perfect friend. And not only that, we thank you for showing us the qualities of a good friend, forgiving our friends, giving our friends good advice, being there for them when they're in trouble. You do it in the most perfect way, and that shows us how we could be a good friend to others. Lord, we ask that you continue to keep us safe and healthy as we are getting ready to begin our third week of online school. And we ask that you just continue to teach us your ways and guide us down your path, Lord, that we may always strive to be on the right path with you. We ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, my friends, and like always, I've got this week's coloring page that I emailed to your family earlier this week. And it has our summary verse that I've told you now a couple of times. I love so much this Bible verse. It's just one of my favorites. No power in the sky above or in the earth below. Indeed, nothing in all creation will ever be able to separate us from the love of God that is revealed in Christ Jesus our Lord. And that comes from Romans chapter 8, and it's verse 39. And we've got a picture of King David over here, and he's playing the harp, singing his praises to God. So this picture comes from another book of the Bible, but that's okay, because since he wrote the Psalms, he wrote all these different songs to God. They are in different books of the Bible. All right, my loves, I hope that you have a great week. I hope that you are adjusting to your distance learning. And I just pray you all have a blessed week. And I will see you next Sunday. Bye, my friends.